Now here we are connecting with our ex-health minister Sudip Roy Barman so that we can know few things from him. And welcome to Halla Bol, Mr. Barman.
Yeah, thank you.
We are very much delighted to have you as a part with us today. I'd like to ask you few questions that are utmost important at this moment.
Okay, go ahead.
Why did you visit the Bhagat Singh COVID Care Center?
Well, I had no plan, honestly speaking.
Okay.
But that lady who complained or who made a, posted a video on the social media.
Right, sir.
I was so touched and literally, so my heart cried for her. And I thought the same would be like for the other patients also over there, staying over there. And I thought of taking stock of the situation myself with my own eyes. And also thought of handing over some things. I'll be going over there to give some fruits and dry fruits to them.
Right.
So that they can feel at home. Had they been at home, they would have availed fruits and all these things which are not available at the COVID care center.
Right, sir.
So I thought of visiting the COVID care center just to have a glimpse of actually what is going on, whether the complaints are genuine or not. And in doing so, I thought, let me hand over some fruits and some dry fruits to them.
Right,
that
sir.
Was my intention of visiting the COVID care
center. Sir, being a public representative, do you have the right to visit a COVID care center?
Yeah. Anybody can visit, probably provided you fulfill the norms. Since I stepped in inside the room, so I had to wear my protection gear, that is the PPE, PPE kit, which the doctors helped me in wearing all those PPE kits. And I went, had a glimpse, and interacted with the patients, keeping a safe distance.
Yes, sir.
So that's what I maintain, all protocols and nothing this area, this Bhagat Singh COVID care center, happens to be in my assembly constituency. So I thought it would be my duty as a public representative, and many patients of my constituents also are admitted over there. So I thought of going over there, and it is very much within the period. You have also seen probably our union health minister, he visiting COVID care center. You have seen a couple of times Hemant Biswa Sarma visiting COVID care center.
Right.
So nothing wrong in it. I have not broken any law.
Sir, following your visit, you have been instructed by the district magistrate West to undergo institutional quarantine for 7 days, and you refused it. Could you please elaborate your point of view regarding this refusal of going for institutional quarantine?
No, actually, this memorandum which was issued probably, it was not in accordance. Some medical experts ought to have come to me. They ought to have taken my sample, and whether I am symptomatic or not, whether I am asymptomatic or whether I am tested positive.
Right.
If all these criteria were fulfilled, and then if I had been tested positive, had they been asked me, I would have, being an abiding citizen, done so. But this memorandum itself is not in accordance with the law, and so absolutely I have got all rights to refuse for any sort of quarantine.
Right. Sir, in your letter to the district magistrate West, you also wrote, because of some vested interest, you have been asked to undergo institutional quarantine. Do you think any kind of conspiracy has been framed against you? If yes, then who is the mastermind behind it?
Well, I need not name the mastermind. It's well known. You did not name anyone.
Right.
People know as to who is behind all these
conspiracies.
And I don't care as to who is conspiring, because I know I'm on the right track. I know I'm fighting for the people. I know whatever I'm doing, it is for the interest of the people. And I'll keep on doing so in the near future also.
Right, sir. So, according to the NCC police stations, an FIR has been lodged against you. We would like to know that the whereabouts of the FIR.
Well, Now, that is also part of the conspiracy, you know.
Right.
That is also a part of the conspiracy, just to you know, bully me or harass me. Nothing more than that. So in the last so many years, when the left front was there, right from the when Mr. Nipen Chakorti was the chief minister, 46 number of cases were there when I was a student leader.
Right.
After that also, when during the tenure of Mr. Manik Sarkar and the Sarat Dev Barma, so many cases were there, all bullshit cases, which is far away from the truth. They have entangled in all those cases also, which I got acquitted from the respective courts. And now again, the same conspiracy is going on against me, because I speak for the people. I don't want the people to be fooled around by the political masters.
Right, sir.
So I keep on telling the truth, and I stood for the truth.
Right
now, so I am standing for the truth. In the future too, also I am standing for the truth and for the people of my state.
Right, sir. So the FIR copy that we came to see, that it was written that your entry to the COVID care center was unauthorized. Do you think so? It was unauthorized.
I have nothing to do. Let them prove. They have to prove that I have. I have done nothing wrong. I have done nothing wrong. I find it in the court, but no problem. No problem. It's all believable fiction. I don't bother about it.
Okay, sir. You mentioned just a few minutes back that 2 days back that a Facebook live of a pregnant lady that just rendered your heart, for which you went to the COVID care center, which became very much viral over the social media platform, where she asked help from the government, showing the unhygienic, pathetic condition in the Bhagat Singh COVID care center. Also, many allegations have come up from various COVID care centers regarding the poor facilities provided by the ruling government. Sir, what do you have to say on this?
I will ask wherever the COVID center exists. I will request all the members of Legislative Assembly of that particular constituency to go to those COVID centers where the PPE kits, take entry and take stock of the situation and get back to the authority whatever problem they observe, those should be mitigated. My intention of going to Bhagat Singh Youth Hostel was, since it falls under my area constituency, I went so that I can get back to the authority. These are the lacunas that exist in Bhagat Singh COVID care center, and this needs to be done so that you can because you know these officers and all these things, these people are sitting in the AC room, they will issue circular.
Right.
But whether on a practical field, these circulars are being followed or observed or not.
I would like to interrupt here a little bit. Sir, the central government guidelines for the COVID care centers, are these followed in the state, where it is written, we came to know that a welcome kit should be given containing a mug, a bucket, some pen, paper, notebook, one-time meal should be provided according to the wish, what he or she likes to take. Sir, is it been followed in the state? If not, then what would you have to say on this?
I didn't get your question. Just repeat the question.
Sir, I was saying that the central government's guideline for the COVID care centers, where it is clearly written that the COVID care patients, as soon as they enter the COVID care centers, they should be given a welcome kit, which would contain a mug, a bucket, a notebook, pen, paper, like so that they can they do not feel any kind of discomfort in the COVID care center. Also, one time meal according to their own wish, what they would like to have. So are these guidelines being followed in the state?
What I was told by the patient and Bhagat Singh, these are not being observed.
Yes, sir. The central government's guideline, you said these are not followed. Now, I would like to say that if you were the health minister, how would you have handled all these, fill these situations related to the COVID care center?
That question is not relevant anymore right now.
Sir, still, as you were our former health minister.
One I can say, had I been the health minister of my state at this point of time, I would have let the battle from the forefront. I would not have kept myself confined within the periphery and just giving video footage or video message to the people of my state. I would have let the warriors from the leading from the front.
I
would not have hide myself in my drawing room.
Right, sir. Sir, last and final question for you. Sir, while interacting with the media persons today, you used a Bengali phrase, koto dhane koto chal. I would like to know, what did you mean by that?
I mean to say, samay apna apna, apna bhi vakt aayega.
Right, sir. Sir, thank you very much for your valuable time, for joining us at Hullabol. Thank you, sir.
It was nice talking to you, and all the best to the Hullabol.
Thank you, sir.